Hello students, welcome back to another video tutorial from Deepak's classes. And in this particular video I will be discussing about the detailed morphological structure, anatomical consideration of the leaf, different modifications of the leaf, and at last I will move towards the basic and most important functions of the leaf. So let's begin. So, as we all know that there are two basic type of plants generally are seen in our nature. One is the flowering and second one is the non-flowering plants. Flowering plants basically means which bears flowers in their structure, and non-flowering plants means which don't possess any kind of flowers in their structure. So, in case of flowering plants, there is presence of another predominant structure that is generally seen in most of the plants universally, that is the leaf. And leaf is the most important part of the plant because it can trap the sunlight and it can convert it into a chemical form of energy, that is the glucose, by photosynthesis. So, in this particular video, you will learn about the different functions of the leaf and most importantly, the structure of the leaf in detail. So you have to watch the video completely and you will learn about the total explanation of the structure of the leaf. So, let's begin. As you all know that leaf is a basic fundamental part of the plant and it appears a flat blade like structure and it appears like a paper. So the flat portion of the leaf is known as the leaf blade or lamina. So I am drawing the structure of the leaf and I will be discussing about the each part of the leaf by point out. So it is the portion of the stem where the leaf will be attached. So, it is the portion of the stem. Now, from here, a leaf is the, what is, a leaf is the outgrowth. Outgrowth from the plant stem, and this outgrowth is like a flat, is appears a flat like, a broad flat paper like structure. So, the flat portion of the leaf is known as the leaf blade or lamina. The portion by which leaf is attached to the stem is known as the petiole. The stick-like structure or the small portion by which leaf is attached by the stem is known as the petiole. Now the portion of the stem at which the petiole is attached is known as the node. Next, the petiole has continuous throughout the structure of the leaf or throughout the blade portion of the leaf. This structure is known as the midvein. Now the midvein is also branched out throughout the different segmented part along the continuous length of the leaf. These parts are known as the veins. So these are the basic structure, these are the basic portions of the leaf that is generally seen in case of typical leaf. Now you can all see the veins which are emerging, which are originating from the midvein, are present in the leaf by a wave like fashion. Now depending on the pattern by which the veins are arranged throughout the leaf is known as the venation. So what is venation? Venation is the pattern by which the veins are arranged in the leaf. There are two types of venation is present within the leaf. One is the reticulate venation and second one is the parallel venation. In case of reticulate venation, the veins will be present in the leaf in a wave-like fashion, in a net-like fashion, like this one. But in case of, so there are two types of venation one is the reticulate and second one is the parallel. In case of reticulate venation, the veins will be arranged like this, wave-like fashion. But in case of parallel venation, the veins will be arranged like this. There will be no overlapping. There will be no overlapping of the veins to each other. So what will be the examples of these reticulate and parallel venation? You can all see the reticulate type of venation in case of mango tree, in case of peepal tree. The type of venation that is seen is generally a reticulate type. But in case of banana leaf, the venation which is generally seen in the leaf is the parallel type. So these are the two basic types of venation that is generally seen in the plant leaf. One is the reticulate venation, the wave-like structure, and the second one is the parallel venation, which is parallel to each other. Now let's move towards the pattern of the leaf originating from the stem. There are three types of pattern by which leaves are originating from the node. The first type of the arrangement is known as the opposite, and the second one will be the alternative type, and the third one will be the hold. So in case of first, that is the alternative, the first, from each node a single leaf will be originating, is known as the alternative. So in case of alternative type of arrangement of the leaf, one leaf will be originating from a single node. In case of opposite, two leaves will be originating from a single node. In case of alternative type of arrangement of the leaves, only a single leaf will be originating from a single node. In case of opposite, two leaves will be originating from the two sides of each node. And in case of hold type of arrangement, a multiple number of leaves will be originating from a single node. So these are the three types of arrangement of the leaves that is generally found in case of all the plants. So now let's move towards the lower surface of the leaf. The lower surface of the leaf generally bears a pore-like structure. That is a small pore-like structure which is guarded by two cells. These two cells are known as the guard cell. And this particular pore is known as the stomata. So what is basically a stomata? Stomata is a pore which is present on the lower side of the leaf. And through this pore, the gaseous exchange, that is the entry of carbon dioxide and exit of oxygen, will occur. So these are the basic stomata which is basically present in the lower side of the leaf. Next, I will move towards the different modification. The first and the foremost important modification of the leaf is the entrap of insects, that is the insectivorous plant. In case of insectivorous plants, the leaf modify into a pot-like structure, and within this pot-like structure, if any insects get entered, and the pots will close its lids, and it will release the different digestive juices, and these digestive juices will ultimately digest the insects. So what are the basic examples of these insectivorous leaves? The first and the foremost important examples of the insectivorous plant is the pitcher plant, sundew, and bladderwort. So these are the three examples. First one is the pitcher plant, second one is the bladderwort, and third one is the sundew. So these are the basic examples of the pitcher plant. Why they entrap insects? Because of the need of nitrogenous protein component. As we all know that plants have to depend upon the nitrogen through the soil. They cannot take nitrogen from the air. So in order to take nitrogen, if the soil does not contain enough amount of nitrogen, then this plant have to trap the insects in order to get the protein content to grow and to develop into further big plant. So these are the basic fundamental modification of the insectivorous plant, and it appears like a pot like structure. So let's now move towards the basic functions of the leaf. The first and the foremost important function of the leaf is the photosynthesis. As we all know that photosynthesis is generally performed by the green parts of the plant, and the most important green parts of the plant is the leaf, because it possesses chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the photosynthetic pigment of the plant. It can trap the sunlight and it can convert this sunlight, the solar energy, into chemical form of energy, that is the ATP, and it will store this energy in the plant. Next important function of the leaf is transpiration, that is the exportation, or that is the removal of water. Removal of water in the form of water vapor. If there is a hot, humid climate, hot, and the plants needs to cool it down, so the extra water will be liberated from the plant as water vapor through stomata, that I have told you earlier, that stomatas are the pore-like structures which are present in the lower surface of the leaf, and through stomata, water vapor will be eliminated and the plants will cool down. And the third most important function is the respiration. Respiration is the gaseous exchange by which plants take carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and releases oxygen to the atmosphere by which we are breathing. So these are the three important functions of the leaf. First one is the photosynthesis, second one is the transpiration, and the third one is the respiration, by which plants exchange the gaseous molecules. Now let's move towards some modifications of the leaf in order to protect itself from its predators. First one is the conversion or the transformation of the leaf into some thorns. There are some specific plants which convert their leaf into a thorn-like structure. And due to the presence of these thorn-like structures, herbivores avoid this type of leaves. So these are the basic protective modification by which plants protect itself. Second modification is the conversion of the leaf into spine. In case of cactus or in case of opuntia, what happens? They transform their leaf into a spine. So there will be a reduction in the transpiration and water will not be eliminated. So it will prevent transpiration and it will entrap the water as much as possible. Third important modification of the leaf is the vegetative propagation. There are some plants like bryophyllum. Bryophyllum is a plant which propagate or which reproduce by the different buds which is present in the leaf. So fourth important functions of the leaf is the vegetative propagation, as it is seen in the bryophyllum. Bryophyllum is basically a plant which bears buds in its leaf, and these buds will be separated from the leaf and it will ultimately produce a different plant. And next, the important functions of the leaf, that there are some plants which convert or which modifies the leaf into some scales, like in case of onions, the leaves are modified into different scales. It will protect the bud inside the scales. So these are the basic functions of the leaf. So what we have studied in this particular video, we have studied the basic structure of the leaf, the pattern of arrangement of the leaves, that is opposite, alternate, whole, modifications of the leaf, that is the insectivorous plant, what are the basic functions of the leaf, and what are by which there are some plants which propagate, which reproduce by the leaf. So these are all about the basic feature and basic functions of the leaf. hope you have liked these videos and you have completely understood the different portion or different functions of the leaf. So do press the like button, and if you haven't subscribed my channel, do subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon.